Hello and a hearty welcome to all my students. This is Ajit Anthony, teacher at Mount Litera Z School, Jhansi. In this video, we are going to discuss chapter number 2, that is components of food. Now, the very first thing that we are going to understand, that is types of food. The food is basically characterized into three main categories, which are bodybuilding food, energy giving food and protective food. As the name itself indicates, bodybuilding food builds our body, whereas energy giving food gives us energy to our body, while protective food protects our body from disease causing microorganisms. Now let us discuss the types of nutrition which we get from the food, that is the category of the food, which are energy giving food, bodybuilding food and protective food. The components of the food are fats, protein, minerals, water, roughage, vitamins and carbohydrates. These are the components or the nutrients which we get from the food. Now let us discuss carbohydrates. Carbohydrates act as a source of energy to our body. That's why they are known as energy giving food. Carbohydrates are of two types, that are sugar and starch. The food which are rich in carbohydrates are honey, rice, wheat, jaggery, potato, etc. Now let us discuss proteins. Proteins are required for the proper growth and to repair the body tissues. They are also known as the bodybuilding food because they help our body to build muscles. The food which are rich in protein are milk, meat, fish, egg, soybean, grams, etc. Now let us discuss fats. Fats are also known as energy giving food because they provide energy to our body. Fats are of two types, first saturated fat, second unsaturated fats. Saturated fats are solid at room temperature like butter and ghee, whereas unsaturated fats are liquid at room temperature, example vegetable oils. The foods which are rich in fats are fish, meat, egg, butter, ghee, oil seed, etc. Excess eating of fat will lead to a condition that is known as obesity, which have many harmful effect to our body and will cause many diseases like heart attack, high blood pressure and cholesterol. That's why we should intake very less amount of fat in our diet. Now let us discuss vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals are known as the protective food, as they protect our body from the disease causing microorganism and also help our body in strengthening the immune system. There are altogether 13 vitamins are there, which are divided into two categories. First, fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. Minerals are also there, present in number of type. They are also required in minute quantity like the vitamin. They also plays a very important role and help our body to remain healthy. All fruits and vegetables are good source of vitamin and minerals.
Hope you all have enjoyed this session. Thank you.